Welcome to the VLAP Lake Sampling Refresher. Before you head out onto the water, there are a few things to remember. First, consult your field manual for a checklist of essential items to make sure your sampling event goes smoothly. We recommend sampling your deep spot once per month during the summer and between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. during peak lake productivity. If you choose to sample on the weekend, sample on a Sunday afternoon to allow for samples to be analyzed within the 24-hour hold time on Monday. You'll want to sample at the same deep spot location each month. The deep spot of your lake has been predetermined by DES biologists based on historical lake bathymetric maps. Navigate to your deep spot and confirm its location using a GPS unit, depth finder, or triangulate your location with three fixed points along the shoreline. Anchor at the deep spot to prevent drifting while sampling. You'll be here for a bit. If drifting does occur, you may need to reposition the boat during sampling. Samples are collected from the middle of each thermal layer at the deep spot. Thermal layers are determined by conducting a temperature profile. Stratified lakes have three layers called the epilimnion, the metalimnion, and the hypolimnion. Unstratified lakes are shallower and have either one or two layers. Samples are collected from the middle of each thermal layer for stratified lakes. For unstratified lakes, samples are collected from the middle of the epilimnion. Consult your field data sheet to see what depths you sampled at the previous year. Either sample at those same depths or conduct a temperature profile to determine layers and sample depths. Instructions are in your field manual. Mark the depths you will collect your samples at on your field data sheet. Next, label your sample bottles. You will fill one large white bottle and one small brown bottle from each depth. This is a set of samples. Next, you will use a Kemmerer bottle to collect the samples. To set up the Kemmerer bottle, thread the calibrated chain or rope through the rod in the middle of the bottle. Clip the chain securely on the end so we don't lose the bottle. And then check to make sure the clip is secure by holding the bottle from the chain. Once the bottle is set up, pull apart both ends to lock the bottle in the open position. When you pull the ends apart, the bottle should click into a locked open position. Lower the bottle into the water column to the desired depth. The chain or rope has a mark every half a meter. Place the mark of the desired depth on the water's surface. Take the messenger, the weight used to close the bottle, and attach it to the chain. Do this over the boat so you don't lose the messenger in the water if you drop it. Then send the messenger down the chain to close the bottle. Once closed, pull the bottle up through the water column. When it reaches the surface, grab the Kemmerer bottle by the rod to lift it out of the water. Then support the bottle on the bottom so it doesn't open up. Remember to check for any sediment in the bottle. If you observe sediment, start over. Sample at a slightly shallower depth or wait for the lake bottom sediment to settle out. Take your large white bottle and fill it with a small amount of water. Rinse the bottle and discard the water, and then fill the white bottle up. Next, pour water from the white bottle into the small brown bottle. Do not rinse this bottle. It contains a small amount of acid as a preservative. Watch carefully as you fill, and only fill the brown bottle to the shoulder. Finally, top off your white bottle with water before you dump the camera bottle. Repeat this process for each depth sampled and place the sample bottles in a cooler with ice. Consult your field data sheet. The next sample you will collect is the chlorophyll A sample. This test estimates the amount of algae in the water column. The starting depth for your sample will be the mid-metalimnion for thermally stratified lakes, or 2/3 the total depth for unstratified lakes. You will fill the large brown bottle here. Note, this bottle does not contain acid. Label your bottle with the starting depth of your chlorophyll A sample. For example, if the mid-metalimnion is 4 meters, label 4 meters on your bottle. There are two methods you can use. The first method is the composite method. This is recommended for lakes where your chlorophyll A sample is collected from a depth of 4 to 5 meters or less. The composite method collects water from different depths and mixes them in a bucket. For example, if your starting depth is 4 meters, you'll want to collect a Kemmerer bottle of water from 4, 3, 2, and 1 meter and mix the water from all 4 depths in the bucket. Indicate on your field data sheet which method you're using and the depths your sample is collected at. Make sure you use a clean bucket. Rinse your bucket with lake water and discard. Lower the Kemmerer bottle to the appropriate depths and close the bottle. Empty the water from the Kemmerer bottle into the bucket from each meter to the surface. If not using a full Kemmerer bottle of water from each depth, make sure you use the same volume of water from each depth. Take your large brown bottle and rinse with water from the bucket and discard. Fill the brown bottle from the bucket and then put it in the cooler. The second method is the integrated tube method. Note, if you're using this method, you're done with the Kemmerer bottle. Unclip the chain in the messenger and put the bottle away. The integrated tube method collects a column of water from the surface to a desired depth at the same time, similar to a big straw. Remember to mark the method and sample depth on your field data sheet. Remember to rinse your bucket. Take the chain and clip it on the eye hook of the weighted end of your integrated tube. The tube should be marked every meter. Next, have one person lower the tube into the water while another person lowers the chain into the water to the desired depth. If your depth is 6 meters, put both the 6 meter mark of the tube and the chain on the water surface. Crimp the top of the tube tight or close the valve. Next, pull the weighted end of the tube up by the chain. Put the weighted end of the tube in the bucket. Release the crimp or open the valve. Then, lift the end of the tube up until all of the water empties into the bucket. Rinse and fill your brown bottle with water from the bucket. Put the bottle in your cooler. Consult your field data sheet. The next thing you'll do is measure lake clarity, or transparency. Transparency is a subjective measurement and can be affected by things such as algae, watercolor, particulate matter, waves, and sunlight. We ask that you measure clarity via two methods, with and without the view scope. Attach the chain to the eye hook on the Psyche disc using the clip. Next, on the shady side of the boat, you'll want to lower the Psyche disc into the water. Have one person watch the disc as it's lowered into the water. Lower the disc until you can't see it anymore. Then raise the disc slowly until you can just make out the white portions of the disc. Mark the chain at the water's surface, and then determine the depth to the nearest tenth of a meter. Record the depth on your field data sheet. Conduct at least two readings, ideally by two separate individuals, and then mark whether you saw the disc on the lake bottom. Move to the sunny side of the boat to use the view scope. Put the end of the view scope in the water and make sure there are no air bubbles and that the end of the scope doesn't leak. Repeat the above process, viewing the Psyche disc through the scope. Record the depths on your field data sheet. That's it at the deep spot. Pack up your equipment and pull up your anchor. You're now ready to conduct your tributary sampling.